In this video, I'll demonstrate how to make chevron friendship bracelets. The materials you'll be needing are 4 color strings. I would advise to cut them between 60 to 70 inches. If the wrist is bigger than a child's wrist, then definitely go for 70 inches. I also advise using a clip and a board or a clipboard. Now take your 4 cut strings and line up the ends together so they're nice and even. This is very important because you do not want uneven strings, because then you'll run out of strings sooner. Fold it in half and then line up the other section of ends together. So now you have altogether 8 strings when you fold it in half. Now I have lined up my 2 ends together and I'm going to fold my strings in half. Now, once I have it in half, I have a loop. This is really important because this is what's going to be like the loop of your bracelet. Take that loop and take it to the edge of your board or your clipboard. Now, with this loop, I'm going to give it a little bit extra on the side because this is where I'm going to make the square knots at. And I'm going to go ahead and clip it at that end right there. And so now I have half the string on one side and half the string on the other side of the back of the clip. Now I'm going to make a forward knot. I'm going to make a forward knot for about at least 8 to 10 forward knots to create the loop. Now, in case you're new to my videos, this is how we do a forward knot. You put one string over all 4 strings, like a 4. And then you put it under the center string and through the loop, and you pull nice and tight up. And you'll do it again, but this time we're going to do it on the other side. Put it under and through the hoop and pull up. And we're going to continue doing it every other side. Under the center string, through the loop, and pull up. And we're going to only be using one color. Then go to the other side after you've completed that and go under the center string, through the loop, and pull up. Make sure that your knots are nice and snug. And you'll continue to do this for at least 8 to 10. Sometimes I do a little extra depending how big I want my loop to be. And again, always go under, through the loop, and up, and continue doing this until you feel that you have enough of the forward knots. Again, 8 to 10 is average. It really is up to you. Sometimes I like bigger loops, sometimes I like tighter loops. So you continue making your forward knots, and once you get about anywhere between 1/2 inch to 1 inch of the forward knots, it's time to remove your forward knots from the clip. Now you can see I have my forward knots, make sure they're nice and snug, and now I'm going to go ahead and fold it together, and I'm going to try to get it folded together nice and tight, and I'm going to put the clip on it, but I do want my edges to show. So that could be a little tricky if your forward knot is not cooperating. Now I do want my little ends to show where my last knots were. So make sure that your knots are showing, because you're going to have to, when you start doing the chevron and finishing up this knot, you want those to connect together. So make sure that those ends are showing through your clips. Now I've got them clipped to the board. I've got my loop clipped to the board, and I want to close that loop up. So I'm going to go ahead and separate off the strings on one side and all the strings on the other side. And you want to put them in order. So here I have yellow, blue, pink, and orange on one side. And I'm gonna do the opposite on the other side. I'm gonna start also with yellow, blue, pink, and orange. So the 2 colors in the middle are gonna be the same color, and then they're gonna go out from there. Okay, so take one side, move the other side away. Take one side, gather the 3 strings that are closest to the center, and take, in my case, the yellow string, the outside string, and make a forward knot. So under the center strings, through the loop, and pull. And then you're going to go ahead and do it again, but on the opposite side. Under the center string, through the loop, and pull. Now, once you're done with those 2 forward knots, move the yellow string away. Pull out your next string, which is going to be your blue. You're going to need to keep them in order. And now we're going to do the same thing with blue. we're going to keep the pink and the orange together. We're going to make a forward knot. Take your forward knot, put it over the two center strings and through the loop, and then do it on the other side. Make the forward knot over the center string, underneath the center string, and through the loop, and gently pulled up nice and snug so your strings are nicely snug. So now we're done with the blue. Put it off to the side. We're left with two. We're going to keep them in order. The next one was the pink. So now the pink is going to go over that string, the orange string, which I call the center string. And you're going to make a forward knot over the orange, under the orange, through the loop, pull up nice and snug. And you're going to do it the opposite side, over the orange, underneath, through the loop, and pull nice and snug. We're done with those two. We're not going to touch the orange right now. We're going to leave it off to the side. We'll use that one later. And we're going to do the exact same thing on the other side in the same order. So go ahead and take your yellow string, pull the other three together, and you're going to do the forward knot again, but opposite way. So this time we're going from the opposite side, and we're going to make that forward knot, and now towards the center, the forward knot. And again, over, under, and through the loop. Now we're done with the yellow, and we're going to start with the blue. Okay, so the blue now will start on the opposite side as well, away from the center. Make the forward knot over the pink and orange, which are now your center string. Over, then under, and then through the loop. And then do the opposite side. Over, under, and through the loop. Now I'm going to take, again, keep them in order, move away the blue. I'm going to take the pink, and I'm going to create the same thing. Sometimes your strings will get a little bit caught up with each other. Just, you know, go ahead and take the time out to separate them. Do a forward knot over the orange, under, through the loop, and now the opposite side, over the orange, under, through the loop, pull gently and snug them together. Now you're going to be left with the two orange strings, and you're going to do a forward knot with those two strings. I'm going to take one side, and I'm going to do a forward knot with that, and that same string I'm going to continue using to make the forward knot. Now, make sure they're nice and tight up there, and they're touching together, because if they get separated, then that separation will remain. So now I'm going to go ahead again and do the forward knot. Pull nice and snug up. Make sure that there's no space. If you do, before you make the knot, second knot, go ahead and pull it together. And now you have your loop completed. Okay, so now we're ready to begin our chevron bracelet. So go ahead and separate your strings and put them all in order. All right, so what we're going to do first is we're going to go in order, yellow to blue, then yellow to pink, and then yellow to orange. And we're going to do the same thing on the other side. We're going to go yellow to blue, yellow to pink, and then yellow to orange. Side and put it off to the other side, because we're not going to be using that right now. And then take your two pink and orange and put them off, because we're not going to use that. And we're going to use the yellow with the blue. So now we're going to do a forward knot. Over yellow, over the blue. This is really important. You can't mess that up. The yellow is the one who's going to do the knot. And then do it twice. Again, another forward knot. Yellow, over the blue, under, and then through the loop and pull gently. Now, take that blue and move it off to the side. We're done with it for now. Now we're going to repeat the same thing. The next order is the pink one. So we're going to do yellow with the pink. So we're going to want to make a forward knot here. I know sometimes the strings, especially when they're long, they get a little tangled up. So just be patient. So forward knot, yellow over the pink, pull the pink down, and then under the pink and through the loop and pull gently. And then you're going to repeat that again in that direction. Yellow over pink, and through the loop. And now you're going to move pink away, and you're going to start with the orange. And then you're going to do the forward knot. Notice the way the forward knot is facing. It's facing to the left. So make a forward knot through over the orange, hold the orange down, and again, do it again. Do the forward knot over the orange, bring it through the loop, the yellow, and pull the yellow up. Don't pull the orange up. And you're done with the orange. This is really important. The yellow ended up in the middle. We'll leave that off to the side right now. We're going to work with it later. And we're going to start on the other side. We're in the same order. You're going to take the yellow over the blue. And make a forward knot. But notice this time the knot is facing to the right. So make the forward knot to the right. So yellow over blue. Or you could consider call it a backward knot. Yellow over blue, under the blue, pull gently the yellow up, hold the blue down, and you're going to repeat this again. This time it's the backward knot. Yellow over blue, underneath, and gently pull up. Okay, so we're done with the blue, put it off to the side. And we're going to start with the pink. You got to keep your strings in order or it messes up the pattern. So we're going to take our string and you're going to do the backward knot, backward forward knot, and then yellow over pink, hold the pink down, this is really important, and pull the yellow up. And then you're going to repeat that again. Yellow over the pink, through the loop, keep the pink down, pull up. Now we're going to do with the orange. And the strings are long at the beginning, so it might be a little bit more difficult maneuvering the strings, but eventually as it gets shorter, it gets easier, and you become better at this. Do the backward knot over the orange and through the loop, and again, backward knot over the orange, pull the orange down and the yellow up. Now we're done with the orange, and our two yellows are in the center, so they changed their orders. And now we're gonna do the backward knot, the backward forward knot, here, and go ahead, keep that one string, that one yellow string down, and you're going to repeat it twice with the same string going down and the same string making the knot. And then go ahead and make that other backward forward knot and pull up. Now switch sides with the strings. You'll notice that it'll kind of go in that direction anyways. And we're going to start again with the same pattern, except this time yellow will be at the end and you will be starting with the blue. So go ahead and put your strings in order so you don't get confused. And as you can see how they changed position, and this is going to happen every single time. So now I'm going to start with the blue with the pink, blue with the orange, and then blue with the yellow. And on the other side, I'll be doing the same. Blue with the pink, blue with the orange, and lastly, blue with the yellow. And then the two blues will come together. So let's get this side out of the way, and let's get the two closest to the center out of the way. And let's start with blue over the pink. The pink, you're going to hold it down. And the blue is going to make the forward knot. Put the blue over the pink, underneath, and through the loop. And pull the blue over. Then again, another forward knot. Blue over the pink, hold the pink down, and gently pull the blue over. And then move the pink out of the way. Now the next color would be orange. So blue over the orange, do the forward knot. And then pull up, keep the orange down. And you'll do it again. Blue over the orange, pull up, and now we're done with the orange, pull it off to the side, and now the blue will do with the yellow. Make sure you have the right yellow. I could have confused them. That's why I say make sure that they'll tell you which way they want to go. Blue over the yellow, and do the forward knot, pull up. They always switch after they come together in the middle. And then do it again. You always want to do it twice. Blue over the yellow. And then pull gently, hold the yellow down. Now we're done with the yellow. And the blues are in the middle. So you're going to keep repeating this on the other side as well. Now go ahead and take your blue string. And we're going to repeat what we did on one side to the other side. So now that I have my blue string, I'm going to do the backward forward knot. Over the pink first, and then gently pull up and repeat it twice. Do the backward knot over the pink, under the pink, and through the loop, and gently pull up. And then move your pink away and go ahead and start with the orange. So grab your orange, which is the next one in line, and do the backward forward knot. Hold your orange down and go ahead and pull the blue up and repeat it again. Backward forward knot and down. We're done with the orange, so you can move the orange away. And now we're going to start with the yellow. So take the yellow, do the backward forward knot, and gently pull up with the blue and hold the yellow down. And again, twice. Pull up with the blue, gently hold the yellow down. You're done with the yellow. And now we're going to bring our two blues together. And we're going to do the forward knot here, or the backward forward knot. I like to do the backward forward knot. So, and you use the same string to do it twice. So hold down the blue that you're holding down, and then repeat it again with the string that you made the knot with. And gently pulled up. And we're done with the blue. And the blue is now in the center of your strings. So the next in line should be, I believe, the pink. So we'll take our pink. And always keep them in order. So now we'll do pink, orange, pink, yellow, pink, blue, and the same on the side, pink, orange, pink, yellow, and pink, blue. So let's start by moving everybody out of the way. And then go ahead and take your pink, and you're going to make the forward knot with the pink over the orange, and gently pull up. And again, the pink or the orange. And basically what we're going to do is we're just going to keep repeating the patterns. But you keep them in order. You repeat in order. So now the next one is the yellow. Do the forward knot with the pink over the yellow. And hold your yellow down. And then repeat it again. The pink over the yellow. Forward knot. And pull the pink up. Yellow's done. And now we start with the blue. And again, you're going to do two forward knots with the blue. And when that is done, you'll begin on the other side. Now I'm going to start on the other side. I'm going to take my pink and my orange string. Move everybody off to the side. Separate to two. Now I'm going to do two backward forward knot with the pink over the orange, and then under and through the loop, and then repeat again. Then once that's done, I'll start with the yellow. I'll do two backward forward knots with the yellow. Always hold down your center string as you pull up. Make sure you do two of them. And make sure they're snug. All right, done with my yellow. Now I start with my blue. Do a backward forward knot, hold down the blue and pull the pink up. And repeat, hold down the blue, pull the pink up. So now I'm done with the blue and my pinks are in the middle. And now I'm going to do the backward forward knot with my pinks. And again, I like to do the backward forward knot with one on the right hand side, and I'll repeat it again. And then once that's done, switch sides with the pinks and do that every single time. So now I've completely done the three colors, and now I'm on my last color, which is the orange. So now I'm going to do the forward knot over the yellow. Gently pull up and make it twice. And you can see how you're starting to see the pattern develop. You can start to see the pattern up above starting to develop. So you just continue through this process. Now I do the blue. Do the forward knot with the orange over the blue. Pull gently. And again, do the forward knot with the orange over the blue. Pull gently. And now I'm going to start with the pink. Do the forward knot over the pink. And then pull gently up. And do that twice. And we're done with that side. And now we can begin on the other side. Start with the orange again. So you're going to do orange and yellow first. Gently pull up, do a backward forward knot, gently pull up, and do another backward forward knot, and gently pull up. We're done with the yellow, put it off to the side, and now you'll do the blue. Do a backward forward knot, hold down the blue as you pull up, do a backward forward knot, hold down the blue as you pull up. Take the blue, put it off to the side, and now we'll do the pink. And do a backward forward knot. Once, then twice. Gently pull up and make sure it's snug. And we're done with the pink, and now we're going to do the two oranges together. And again, the backward forward knot. Use the same string. One more time, same string. I didn't switch strings. I'm using the same string to do the backward forward knot. Gently pull. Once you've done that, switch string sides. And we've completed an entire set from yellow, blue, pink to orange. And now you're seeing your pattern develop. So now we've completed a whole set, and you're going to repeat this process all over again. And you'll continue on, and you'll see as your bracelet grows. And when you get near the end, you will stop. I usually stop a couple of inches from the end, like maybe 2 inches from the end, because then you're going to make the little ends for the bracelets. Now I'm finishing up my bracelet. I've measured it. It's definitely long enough, so I'm going to start now finishing off my ends so I could tie my bracelet. So first what you do is you take one section and you take 2 strings, and we're going to take those 2 strings, which is the pink and the blue, and I'm going to do a backward forward knot with the pink and the blue. Not a forward knot, a backward forward knot just with the pink and the blue. And so over the blue, under the blue, and through the loop, and gently pull up. And I'm going to do that twice. I'm going to take the pink over the blue, under the blue, through the loop, and pull up. All right, so I've done those 2, and now I'm going to take my next color, and I'm going to do my orange over the pink and the blue. So backward forward knot over the blue. This is how we tie it off. I mean over the pink and blue, under it, pull up gently and snugly. Do it twice. Over, under, and through the loop. Okay, now we're gonna put those 3 together, and we're gonna get the last color, which is the yellow. Now how you end up in color, it doesn't really matter. This is how I ended up. Through, under, and over. Through, under, and over. Again, it doesn't matter what last colors you ended up and what order you ended up. as long as they follow the order. In this case, my blue was, you know, at the end, one end, and the yellow the other end. So I'm just using it this way. So now I'm going to take my pink over my blue, do a forward knot. So I'm going to do a forward knot over my blue. And you're going to do this twice. Forward knot. Put them together. And take your next color in line, which is the orange. And you're going to do a forward knot over the other two colors. Over, under, and gently pull. And then forward knot over, under, and gently pull. Make sure they're snug, the knots. All right, so now we have one last color, yellow. So you're going to put the yellow over the three colors, forward knot, over, under, gently pull. And one more time. Do it twice to each color. Okay, so I have two sections knotted off, and now you have a choice. You can braid both of them, or you could do a twist. Since I have four, I'm going to go and braid with two together and each two separately. So I'm just going to do a regular braid, nothing fancy. Just do your typical braid and braid it all the way down. Be careful that your bottom doesn't get tangled. Go long enough that you could use it to tie on the loop. Also, if you don't want to make a friendship bracelet, you can make a keychain. I've made keychains with these and put them on my keychain. I love the bright colors, and I find that it's easier to find with my keys when they're stuck in my purse. And they just look great. So this one, I'm just going to braid it down as far as I like. And then I'm going to tie it into a knot when I get to that point. So I'm going to be demonstrating two different styles you could do. The braiding is my favorite, but some people like the twist as well. They both look just as beautiful. All right, so just make a knot. Off, and then you can cut the ends where you want to. Before I cut the ends, I usually do my other side so that they're even, and I cut them at the same time. So on this one, this is the twist. Take two, take two strings on each side, put them together, and start twisting. Now you got to make sure that you twist really tight, because if not, it comes unravel. It wants to turn with you, but don't let it turn with you. Just twist as tight as you can. Keep it super, super tight. And pull as you twist so that it tightens up. Now you want to go as low as the other one did, or as long, better yet, as your other one. So you're going to have to keep an eye on how long you went with the other one. Now if you're doing two braids, you can do two braids. If you want to do two twists, do two twists. I just demonstrated two different styles here so that you can do either one. It's all about preference. measure it. Do a little extra because you always have to tie that knot. So there's this. I always do a little extra because since I have to tie the knot, I want to make sure it's nice and tight. Go ahead and do your knot. About the same distance. Tie it tight. Now you have those. And go ahead and take a scissors and cut it off where you'd like it to be. And you have done a beautiful job on your chevron bracelet. So now you've completed your chevron bracelet and you could give it to a friend or wear it. The way you put it on is you take one of the long little pieces and put it through the hoop and tie it with the other one. I suggest you double knot it so it doesn't fall off. This is a great way to adjust it. You could make it tighter or looser. I hope you enjoy making your chevron friendship bracelet.